Here's why you should probably still pay for ChatGPT. So a couple of days ago, OpenAI released a new model called GPT-4O. The O stands for Omni, and it's their new model, which is available for free for everybody. In terms of performance, it's on par with the current paid model, GPT-4. It's also much faster. So this has led lots of people to say, well, why do I need my premium subscription? The best, newest model is now available for everyone for free. So why am I paying $20 a month? Really good question, and I asked this yesterday and got a lot of responses from various different people. Based on the feedback I got, here's why you should hang on to your subscription. If you like this kind of update, make sure you're following, and there's a newsletter in the bio. So a few days ago, it was not clear what the premium users were going to be getting that the free users would not. Now we know for sure that what's going to be happening is the free users are going to get access to GPT-4o, which is the best model. That's great. But they're severely rate limited. I had reports of people yesterday who were able to put in about 5 queries before being cut off. And when you get cut off, you get bumped all the way from GPT-4o back to GPT-3.5, which is really not good enough. If you have a paid plan, then you continue to be able to use GPT-4o as much as you want. So right now the servers are overloaded, so the limitations on the free users are probably the highest they're ever going to be. Therefore, free users are going to be allowed to use more of GPT-4o in the future, very likely, but it's still going to be a limited use. The second big factor here is privacy and data protection. If you are on the free plan of any AI, and this is going to be across the board, your data, your information, your inputs and your outputs is going to be used to train the model. If you are on a paid or premium plan on any AI, you generally have the ability to tell it not to use your information. So if you are using AI for business purposes and you want to keep that data protected to your internal documentation, for example, I'd recommend using a paid plan. Third, it's been confirmed that the paid version of ChatGPT is going to have new features added soon. At the announcement on Monday, they talked about the new conversational assistant. So Dan is getting replaced with a real-time conversation assistant that you can talk to and it responds immediately in a few milliseconds. And it can also detect your emotion and portray its own emotion. That's only going to be available for paid plans, not for the free plan. And the same will go for the new video chat feature where you're able to scan things in the environment and ask questions about it. That is also going to be paid, not free. So basically what we're seeing is text and image can be done on the free plan, but you're going to have a limitation in how much you can use it and your data is going to be used to train the model. If you're on the paid plan, you're going to have text, imagery, audio conversations and video as well as no limitations, and your data is going to be protected and not used for training. So I hope that's cleared up some of the confusion, because OpenAI have not been very good at communicating this. So tell me, will you be using the paid version or the free version?